Hey fellow workers, my name is Kim Seaver. Welcome back to my channel. Before I get into the main message of my video, let me shout out my newest monthly paid subscribers. Pat McComb, Christine Frolick, Krista Searle, Jonathan Clark, Aaron Pink, Heather Stocking, Deb Wolchuk, and D. McLeod. Donations like yours make videos like this possible. Now on to the rest of my video. The only way conservative governments can increase corporate profits is to decrease corporate taxes. After all, corporate taxes are based on how much profit your company makes. The higher your profits, the more you pay in taxes. For example, let's say your corporate profits in a tax year are $1 billion. If the corporate tax rate is 12%, then you'd theoretically pay $120 million, leaving you with $0.88 billion in profits instead of $1 billion in profits. If the tax rate is 8%, then you'd theoretically pay $80 million, leaving you with $0.92 billion in profits instead of $1 billion. You'd have an extra $40 million in profits under the lower tax rate. The problem with lowering corporate tax rates is that it lowers provincial revenue. In the 2018-2019 Alberta budget, when the tax rate was 12%, corporate tax revenue was $4.97 billion. As of the most recent fiscal update, corporate tax revenue was forecasted to be $4.39 billion, and that's with 12% April to June, 11% July to December, and 10% January to March. That's a loss of $580 million. And if you campaign on balanced budgets, the only way to accommodate reduced revenues is to decrease expenses. In this case, the provincial government would have to find a way to cut $580 million from the budget. Conservative governments don't cut healthcare because they hate public healthcare or that they think private healthcare is better. They cut healthcare because they have less revenue from their tax cuts to increase corporate profits. They bring in private healthcare as a way to continue offering healthcare while they reduce funding for healthcare. They don't cut education because they hate public education or that they think private education is better. They cut education because they have less revenue from their tax cuts to increase corporate profits. They bring in private education as a way to continue offering education while they reduce funding for education. Same goes for larger classroom sizes, increased school fees, and so on. They don't cut post-secondary funding because they hate post-secondary education. They cut post-secondary education because they have less revenue from their tax cuts to increase corporate profits. Same goes for tuition increases and the commercialization of post-secondary education. They don't use private-public partnerships because they hate funding public infrastructure or they think private enterprise is better at public infrastructure. They use private-public partnerships because they have less revenue from their tax cuts to increase corporate profits, and so on. You see, conservative governments cut expenses because they need to save money from reduced revenues, which are reduced because of their tax cuts, which are cut to increase profits for companies. That's it. That's the whole story. Thanks for watching. Thanks to all these subscribers and Patreon patrons who make this video possible. Please visit my website at kimseaver.ca. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, and Medium. If you appreciate the videos I share on YouTube, the posts I write on my blog, and the content I share on my other social media accounts, please consider making a monthly donation either through PayPal or Patreon. If you agree with the points I raise in my video, please give me a thumbs up and let me know in the comments below why. Please share my video and subscribe to my channel. I look forward to talking to you again soon. Solidarity.